Hey guys, I'm here with Tina. How's your first day yesterday?
Good.
Did you come to school yesterday?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, I did too. It's the second day of school. It is about 12. Actually, I think James is right there. Hi. Would you like to say hello to the camera? This is James, and I'm going to be doing a flick duet with him. It's going to be lots of fun. Alright guys, so it's time to run. It is 1:08. I'm about to go to my early music ensemble audition, and I have no idea where it is. Yeah, so.
It is currently 5:23. You're probably wondering what has happened since 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock, James and I found a room after going to the basement, to the fourth floor. And of course, there's no rooms available on the third floor. We finally found a room in the second floor, but it was very cramped. But at least we landed two stands. We rehearsed for about 45 minutes or so. Everything is going very well. Awesome job, James. And then there's this huge, I don't even know if you can call it drama, because I couldn't find the room that I was supposed to audition in for the early music ensemble. That was a bit of a gong show. I wrote about it in my blog. I warmed up a bit until about 1:15. My audition was at 1:30. Now, the old auditorium is just like across from the music building. It's literally like just whoop and you're there. When I got to the building, none of the doors would open, and I was just like, oh my god! I went back to the music front office, and they told me that I needed the key fob. If you guys watched the video from yesterday, it's this, right? But there wasn't any, like, detector box next to any of the doors that I went to. I mean, like, I'm not blind. Like, I'm wearing glasses, but I'm not blind. Then I go back to the old auditorium to try, but I can't find the key fob little detector thing. I went back to the music building, looked on the sign-up sheet again for the audition, and the audition location was room 413 of the music building. So I was like, okay, great. So I went all the way upstairs because the elevator wasn't fast enough, and finally got to the room. Sure enough, on the door, there's a sign that says auditions are being held at the old auditorium in room 304. I'm like, great, I can't even get into the building. I'm freaking out, I'm starting to sweat, I'm looking at the clock all the time. And then suddenly I see Neil, and I was just like, oh my god! I don't even remember, like, how I got him to come with me. I'm just like, it's just all a blur right now. He came with me to try and find the door, but he didn't know where it was either. We ran into our voice major friend, Maria, and we asked her how to get into the old auditorium because voice majors tend to know the old auditorium better. So we asked her and she told us to try the side door. And we're like, what? There is actually a ramp on the side of the building. I had thought that that ramp was for like people toting up really heavy things or something like that, right? To like the back of the building. But no, we went up that ramp and literally like right in front of us on the side of the building are like two sets of giant double doors with the little key fob detector box thingy in the middle. And I was like, oh my god. So I suddenly realized the front doors are actually on the side of the building. You feel like you're going into like an alley when you go to the front of the old auditorium. Like, what? So anyway, I finally got in. I did my audition, and the audition went amazing. Like, it was really good. I think it's because I really like Bach, and I've wanted to play the Baroque flute ever since I heard that, you know, there is early music here in Vancouver. And like, I'd be watching YouTube videos of professionals doing it, and I'm just like, oh, so cool. I played the Bach sonata that I did for my third year recital, and if you're interested in watching me do that, I'll put a link like right here. Dr. Fisher, who is directing the ensemble, is so nice. Like, wow. I actually had him as my first year music history prof. Doreen, the I believe she's the Baroque keyboardist teacher prof Yeah. She was so nice, too. I played a page of the Bach Sonata for them, and they loved it. They thought that my attempts at imitating period practice to be very interesting. I think they actually liked it. Basically, I wasn't using any vibrato whatsoever, and I only have a very limited knowledge of period practice, but I did what I could and I didn't do vibrato. What'll be really fun is if I can actually play that sonata again on the Baroque flute and record it again for you guys. That'd be so cool. Maybe I should do that. I got the audition done within 10 minutes, probably. It actually didn't take that much time for the whole drama to happen. It was only like within half an hour, but it felt like forever. Like, it was just like, oh my god. But anyway, the audition went so well. I'm so happy. So at 3:30, I went to the Chan Center to have a meeting with basically everybody who's interested in taking a chamber ensemble, which is a small group of musicians. So like for me, it's wind quintet, right? We're already a preformed group, although we are still looking for a new bassoonist and a new clarinetist. We're talking to one of the wind coaches about that to match us up with people who are compatible with us, because personality matters. So we had basically, it was like an hour and a half long meeting about all the stuff that we need to know for recitals. They have renovated the new recital hall. It's now called the Roy Barnett, I think, recital hall. And from the outside, I can already tell that it looks amazing. So we had a huge meeting about that, and also talking about special talks about, you know, like performance etiquette, marketing yourself as a musician, new media, breathing posture, blah blah blah, just like a whole bunch of stuff that, you know, would be very helpful to us as musicians who are looking to make a career out of music. And then there's this huge scheduling thing that we have to do now, which is always a nightmare. The beginning of the year scheduling rehearsals for quintet is a nightmare, I tell you, because everybody has different schedules. Even if four people can make it, sometimes one person can't, and it's just like, ah! Last year we ended up doing a lot of early morning rehearsals, like 8 a.m. I mean, if we have to do it, then we have to do it. I mean, like, for me, it's for the team. If we can't meet at humane times, then we'll just have to meet at 8 a.m. in the mornings. We have to have at least 2 hours of rehearsal in addition to an hour of coaching per week. I did have an English class earlier today. It was more of a stress relief to me, really. I mean, most people don't think of English as stress relief, but it sort of makes me realize that the world is a lot bigger than just the classical music department here. Anyway, I'm done now, and I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna eat, and I'm going to prepare a whole bunch of stuff for tomorrow. And yeah, so we'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!